Hey guys, I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and this is the brand new DJI Phantom 4. Some cool new features are the advanced autopilot, auto-follow modes, and object avoidance. Also, my favorite new feature is sport mode, where I can go flying up to 45 miles per hour. Now, before we even open the box, the included styrofoam is actually a carrying case with rubber handle and locking mechanism. This will make an awesome carrying case until I pick up a new hard shell backpack. Or maybe I can modify my current Phantom 3 backpack as it just barely doesn't fit. Okay, so quick specs overview. There's a new larger battery, 5350 milliamps with flight times up to around 28 minutes. Transmission range is 3.1 miles while still maintaining an HD live video feed. Quick sidebar, I actually had a few issues with this where the video feed would cut out periodically at far distance, but then reconnect a short moment later. I also received a weak RC signal notification, so this kind of concerns me as I never had these issues with my Phantom 3 Pro, but hopefully these are just early software bugs that will get worked out. The camera sensor looks about the same, they just upgraded the lens. It can still do 4K at 30 frames per second, but now it supports 120 frames per second at 1080p for ultra slow motion. I noticed there's a bit of lens crop when you jump to this resolution and frame rate, and the picture quality is a little soft, but it's definitely still usable footage, and since I can shoot in D-Log, there's plenty of room for color grading and producing some really fantastic shots. I do wish they added 2.5K or 4K 60 frames per second, but maybe in a future update. Video bitrate is still 60 megabits per second, and I can capture 12 megapixel DNG raw stills. Oh, and one really cool update are the new push and release propellers. They're faster to install and more secure. Overall design is amazing. DJI is really feeling like the Apple company of drones. Everything is bright white, glossy, shiny, and sleek, soft touch plastic, reversible charging cables, no exposed wiring on the skids anymore, ventilation slots in the battery, even the boot up sound is a lot sexier. A lot of thought has gone into each design element and it really shows. When I first powered on, I had to update the quad and the remote control, but man, it's so easy compared to how it used to be. No more connecting to a computer, it's all updated through the app. So, how's flying? It's dreamy. So quick and responsive. You can tell that normal GPS safe mode is a little bit slower due to the object avoidance sensors, but still flies great. In the safe mode, if you're flying straight towards an object, it will auto-stop and prevent the crash. I think this is a huge step in the right direction for safer flying and giving beginner pilots more confidence. However, I think it's a huge bummer these sensors are only in the front and not the sides or the back or the top. Honestly, a ton of my aerial shots are pull back and away or side strafing dolly shots, and that's when it's easy to crash into something because the camera isn't pointed in those directions. I do think this will definitely be updated in a future model with sensors pointing in all directions. A cool bonus with these sensors though is when you hit the return to home button, it's using object avoidance to come back safely. Very nice. Next up, subject tracking. With a simple tap on the screen, the Phantom 4 will automatically track and follow your subject. No need for a GPS wrist strap or even holding the remote control anymore. In my testing, it actually worked great. The object needs some good contrast from its background and it can't be too small or far away. But for the most part, if I tracked myself or even on a moving car, it locked on and followed the whole way. Really, really cool. As a bonus to this feature, if I'm tracking an object and I press left or right on the right stick, it will orbit around the object while it's automatically following and tracking with it. This makes for some really cool and complex shots. In TapFly mode, I can just tap on the screen and the Phantom will fly in that direction. I can determine its speed and with object avoidance, it will auto-avoid objects along the way, all while keeping a smooth flight path for smooth camera shots. Tap another point and it will continue in that direction. So it's kind of like setting up a flight path or cable cam without needing to use the map. Plus, the controller has a new pause button, so at any time if I hit the pause, the Phantom will freeze right where it's at. Now my favorite feature, sport mode. Flip the switch down to S on the remote and start cruising at 45 miles per hour. Yaw rate is insane, hyper responsive controls, feels like I'm flying a jet fighter. I can't wait to get myself FPV goggles, this will be a ton of fun. Okay, so the current price is $1,400. Is it worth the upgrade from the Phantom 3? Well, it really depends. I'd say if you're gonna be using a lot of subject tracking, plus maybe you really need some fast aerial shots with speed mode, or you just want to experiment with drone racing, then you'd probably really appreciate the upgrade. If you're an intermediate or pro flyer with the Phantom 3 Pro, you still have that same great 4K camera, and you'll probably be fine sticking with what you have. If, however, this might be your first DJI or aerial cinema drone, the P4 might be worth spending those extra dollars, giving you object avoidance and a ton more safe flying features. Now, if you have any drone questions, leave them down below. I'll try my best to help out. If you're interested in buying the new Phantom 4, I'll give you those links in the description. Be sure to hit that thumbs up and subscribe button if you enjoyed this content. And until next time, let's live the AuthenTech life.